All right, number six. This is an inequality. You solve it just like an equation, except if you multiply or divide by a negative, you have to switch the inequality sign. All right, so the first thing we want to do is get the variables on the left side and the constants on the right, or the opposite of that. So I'm going to subtract 9x from both sides. So I have my variables on this side. So if the variables are on this side, on the left, then I'm going to add 7. So the constants are on the right-hand side. So that gives me negative 5x is still less than negative 2 plus 7 is 5. All right, now you want to divide by a negative 5, so that means you got to switch the inequality sign. So when you divide by negative 5, that's going to switch. So it's the opposite direction, so it'll be greater than x is greater than negative 1. All right, so let's see if this is going to make sense. Since it's not equal to negative 1, I have to put a circle on it, not a dot. It says x is bigger, so you have to pick numbers bigger than negative 1. Now I said check that a point in your solution makes the original inequality true. Let's check x equals 0. So I'm going to check x equals 0 into, this is my check, into 4x minus 7 less than 9x minus 2. So we're going to put in 0 for x and see if this is a true inequality. We're not checking to see if both sides are equal. We're making sure the left side is less than the right-hand side. Well, if you put in 0 for x, it's an easy number to plug in. I get 0 minus 7, so that's negative 7. And 0 minus 2 is negative 2. And is negative 7 less than negative 2? Yes. So it checks. So that means this is the correct solution. X is greater than negative 1. Do not leave this as less than. Over here, when you have negative 5x less than 5, as soon as you divide by negative 5, you need to erase and change it to greater than, or cross it out, circle it, do something. Okay, next one. Negative 3x is greater than 9. So we're going to divide both sides by negative 3. And here it goes again. I just divided by a negative, so that's not true that it's greater than or equal. It's the opposite direction, so it's going to be less than or equal. So x is less than or equal. 9 divided by negative 3 is negative 3. All right, let's see. So it's less than or equal to negative 3. So this means it's negative 3 is one of the solutions. So we put a dot on it, and now we go to the left. Now 0 is not a solution, right? So if we plug in 0, it should show we should get a false. So the question is, I'm going to check x equals 0. Is that false? So I'm going to take negative 3x is greater than or equal to 9, the original, and we're going to put in 0. And this says 0 is greater than or equal to 9. Yeah, it's false. So that means it's correct that 0 is not a solution. So we do have it going the right direction. We don't want it to go through 0. One angle of a triangle is 3 times as large as the smallest angle, and the measure of the third angle is 40 more than that of the smallest angle. Also, the measure of the three angles add up to 180 degrees. So we need to define, set up an equation, solve it, check it, etc. All right, so it says one angle is 3 times as large as the smallest angle. Well, that means I need to know what the smallest angle is, so let's let the smallest angle be x. Now we've got one angle is 3 times as large as the smallest angle. Okay, so if the smallest was x, then the other one is 3 times as large as that, so 3 times x. The measure of the third angle is 40 degrees more than that of the smallest, so it's 40 degrees more than what the smallest was. So if the smallest was x, this is x plus 40. Now, we know that when we add the three angles together, we get 180. So we're going to add those three angles together. The first angle is x. The second angle is 3x. The third angle is x plus 40. Those are three angles. Must add up to 180 degrees. So what do we have here? 1x plus 3x plus 1x. Remember there's a 1 in front of here if you don't see it? So 5x plus 40 equals 180. All right, so we need to get the variables on one side and constants on the other. So I need to subtract 40 from both sides. So I have 5x equals 140. And then divide both sides by 5. So x is 28. Now remember, we're talking about the measure of some angles, so that must mean 28 degrees. The smallest angle is x, right? So remember what we had, x, this was x, the next one was 3x, so 3 times 28 would be 84 degrees. And the third angle was x plus 40, so 28 plus 40 is 68 degrees. Now let's check and make sure those add up to 180 degrees. 28 plus 84 plus 68 does add up to 180 degrees. That's true. And also, let's see, is it true that one angle is 3 times the smallest? Yep. 3 times 28 is 84. And is it true that one angle is 40 degrees more than the smallest? Yes, this third angle is 40 degrees more. So everything checks out. So those are our angles of this triangle, and we've checked it. All right, we're continuing with the solutions to the practice test for the Elementary Algebra Final. Right, so we want to find the slope given of the line that goes through the two given points. All right, so for this first one, remember the slope is the change in the y's over the change in the x's. So we set it up like this for each of them. And we want to take one ordered pair and put the y over the x. So let's put the negative 6 over the 4 here. And the other ordered pair, and you put its y over its x. And we'll do that over here too. We'll take the first ordered pair and put the y value over the x value, the y coordinate over the x coordinate. And for the second one, the y coordinate over the x coordinate. And for the third one, we'll take one of the ordered pairs and put the y coordinate over the x coordinate. And the last ordered pair, we'll put the y coordinate over the x coordinate. If you set it up like this, it makes it easier to do. So then we have to say what's negative 6. This is going to be plus positive, right? So negative 6 plus 2 is going to be negative 4 on the top. And this is also going to be plus plus. 4 plus 5 is 9. So the slope of this first one is negative 4 ninths. Second one, negative 7 minus negative 7. Well, that's going to change to plus plus. So I'm going to get 0 over 3, which is 0. If 0 is in the numerator and not in the denominator, the answer is 0. And if you plotted these two points, you should get a horizontal line. Right, in this other one, 4 minus 8 is going to give you negative 4 over 8, and that reduces to negative 1 half. Negative 1 half.